Is laughter the best medicine for depression? Hey everyone, Crystal here for DNews. Nitrous oxide, better known as laughing gas, is a molecule composed of two nitrogen and one oxygen atoms that is best known for making us laugh. The gas has a lot of medical applications due to its analgesic as well as its anesthetic properties. That means it can relieve our pain and cause us to lose consciousness. You might have already encountered this ubiquitous gas in your dentist chair, or at that party that one time where you were trying to figure out how to use the pressurized whipped cream maker and accidentally inhaled gas from a canister. Humans exposed to laughing gas report feeling dizziness, euphoria, and, well, happy. This is probably obvious from the side effect that gives the gas its common name, laughing. These known side effects of nitrous oxide exposure got researchers at the Washington University in St. Louis thinking, why not use laughing gas to treat depression? In a study published recently in the journal Biological Psychiatry, patients diagnosed with treatment-resistant clinical depression received two therapeutic exposures to gas. In the first treatment session, patients were given gas that was half oxygen and half nitrous oxide, similar to what you're given at the dentist. In the second session, the patients were given gas that was only a mixture of oxygen gas and nitrogen gas, so basically air. The study participants were asked to answer questions about their depressive symptoms, like insomnia, sadness, anxiety, and suicidal thoughts, 2 hours, and again 24 hours after the treatment. 24 hours after the nitrous oxide exposure, patients reported mild or significant improvements in their depressive symptoms. 3 of the 20 study participants reported that their symptoms had disappeared almost completely. But it should be noted that researchers observed some placebo effects in those who received the gas mixture that did not contain nitrous oxide. 5 patients reported mild improvement, and 2 reported that they felt significantly better. Additionally, the researchers only analyzed the effect of nitrous oxide exposure after 24 hours, which is not a lot of time to see a prolonged effect, and certainly too short of a time after treatment to be able to say that depression was cured. There are a few other things to keep in mind. This was a proof of concept study, and only 20 people participated. A much more statistically robust study with possibly hundreds of participants would be needed to make any conclusions about the effectiveness of nitrous oxide treatments on those with clinical depression. But these results are still encouraging. If nitrous oxide does cause short-term improvements in depressive symptoms, it could be a good way to treat immediate effects of the disease, while patients and their doctors wait for prescribed psychiatric medications to take effect. It can take weeks for patients starting on conventional psychotropic drugs to experience relief of their symptoms, and patients can continue to suffer while the drugs build to full potency. Obviously, more research is needed. But even if laughing gas doesn't cure depression, it could be a tool for doctors to use on critical patients who need immediate help. What do you think? Does this study give you hope for treating depression? Subscribe to DNews and let us know in the comments down below. And you can also come find me on Twitter at PolyCrystalHD.